As per the syllabus, the next topic there in the first unit is similarities and differences between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Here, first we are going to see what are the similarities that have been existing between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes, and then the differences. Basically, the similarity were proposed by Stanier and Van Neel. The common thing between a prokaryote and eukaryote is both the cells have been bounded by a plasma membrane. The second similarity is the genetic information of the prokaryotes and eukaryotes are commonly coded by DNA. And the third point is ribosome is the one which acts as a site for protein synthesis both in prokaryote and eukaryote. However, there is a small difference existing there in the rRNA, that is ribosomal RNA of the prokaryote as well as the eukaryote. That is, the rRNA of prokaryote is of a 50S and 30S type. However, eukaryote is of a 60S and 40S type. We look at some more differences in the ribosome between a eukaryote as well as a prokaryotic ribosome. The eukaryotic ribosome is composed of 5 kinds of rRNA and it has about 80 different kinds of proteins. The ribosome synthesis takes place in cytoplasm as well as in the nucleolus of the cells. However, the prokaryotic ribosomes are composed only of 3 different kinds of rRNA and it has only about 50 different kinds of protein compared to that of the eukaryotic ribosome. The ribosome synthesis in the prokaryotic cell will be commonly taking place only in the cytoplasm. So, difference between these two ribosomes have been shown there in this diagram. If you look at into the diagram, you can able to see the difference between the two ribosomes. Prokaryotic 70S ribosome, it is divided into 50S and 30S. The 50S is further divided into 23S as well as 5S rRNA with 34 proteins, whereas 30S is the one which is composed of 6S rRNA. All these things together constitutes the 70S ribosome of the prokaryote. If you look at into the eukaryote, it is made up of a 60S and 40S. Again, that has their subsequent subunits. Now we will look at the difference between both prokaryote as well as eukaryotic organisms. The cell size and volume. The prokaryotes are of 1 to 10 micrometer. However, the eukaryote is of 10 to 100 micrometer in length. Diameter of the prokaryote is 0.5 to 5 micrometer. They are even up to a 40 micrometer in diameter. Prokaryotes will be having a high surface area to volume ratio. The eukaryotes will be having a low surface area to volume ratio. The surface area to volume ratio has been explained very clearly here in this diagram. What happens to the surface area and volume ratio when the size is increasing? Okay, so the surface area to volume ratio is very high there in a small sized organism. However, the surface area to volume ratio is very small in large size organism. So that is the reason why it has been referred that bacteria are having a very high surface area to volume ratio. The next trait is the appearance of the organism, that is form of the organism. Here it is a unicellular. Commonly prokaryotes are unicellular and they are rarely filamentous. One filamentous form of a unicellular organism, that is a prokaryote, is a cyanobacteria that may be having some filaments. However, eukaryotic organisms are unicellular as well as multicellular and they are filamentous in nature. All these things will be common there. However, most of the eukaryotic organisms are truly multicellular in appearance or multicellular in nature. The next point is related to the cell wall of the organisms. Bacteria will be usually made up of murine, that is murine composed of the cell wall of the bacteria. Murine was in turn made up of N-acetyl glucosamine and N-acetyl muramic acid. However, archaea found to have a pseudomurine. A small change there in the composition of the murine is different there in the archaea. So that is the reason it is referred as a pseudomurine. However, the eukaryotic organisms are having different kinds of things in their cell wall. But an interesting thing is animals do not have a cell wall. They have only cell membrane. Plants will have a cell wall. Algae will have a cell wall that is made up of cellulose. Cellulose is a polymer that has been present there in the cell wall. And fungi is again a eukaryotic form which is having chitin in their cell wall. Chitin is present in the fungal cell wall. Apart from that, chitin is commonly present there in the insects. And even on the crab shell, you can able to find a lot of chitin. So here, during the molting of an insect, you can able to see the chitinaceous shell in the downside. And a newly molted insect has been coming out there in the top angle. Next, we will look at the differences there in the genetic features that have been existing there between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Genome-wise, DNA is present there freely in the cytoplasm and it is not bounded by nuclear membrane. This point is the one which we are discussing from a very early time. Whereas here, the DNA is contained within the nuclear membrane and thus it has a bound nucleus. That is, nucleus is bounded by a nuclear membrane. However, such kind of a nuclear membrane is not present there in the prokaryotes. Previously, they used to say Pyrolella and Gemmata were exception. That is, they found to have a nuclear membrane. However, it was later identified that they have been simply the artifacts there formed during the preparation of specimen for viewing in the microscope. Next one is chromosome. Usually is a single circular chromosome, or it is commonly referred as a nucleoid. Whereas in the eukaryotic organisms, multiple linear chromosomes, they are not circular, note the point, they are linear chromosome occurring in pairs. In the circular chromosome of the prokaryotes also, some differences are existing there between some organisms. One example is Borrelia burgdorferi is an organism which found to have a linear chromosome like that of the eukaryotic organism. And it's usual that they will be having a single chromosome. Whereas Burkholderia sepacea found to contain three different chromosomes housed within that particular organism. So this one is the genome of the Burkholderia. You can able to see three different chromosomes that have been present there. The next point is related to protein synthesis in the genetic features. There is a clear difference existing between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes there in the mechanism of protein synthesis. If you look at prokaryotes, they have a transcription coupled translation process, which is a very common feature. However, if you look at into the eukaryotes, transcription and translation are temporally and spatially separated. That is, transcription and translation are separated in the time scale as well as in the space. So this thing can be better understood if you are able to look at this diagram. See, this diagram that is shown in the left hand side indicates the transcription coupled translation which is taking place there in the prokaryotic organism. You can look at here the DNA of the prokaryotic organism. It has been just read with the RNA polymerase enzyme that results in the formation of the mRNA molecule. So in this mRNA molecule, while the process of the transcription is going on, the translation is coupled. That is, during the process of transcription itself, translation is also happening with the help of numerous ribosomes that are sitting there on the mRNA molecule that results in the production of new polypeptide at the same time. So, transcription and translation both are coupled together in the prokaryotic organism. However, if you look at into the eukaryotic organism that is shown there in the right hand side, transcription and translation are spatially, space-wise they are separated. Say for example, this is a region in which transcription is being taking place. And they are temporally separated, that is time-wise also they are separated. So in this space, transcription is taking place and then the translation is taking place. At one time, transcription is taking place. After another time or after a particular time only, the translation process is taking place there in the eukaryotes. That is, if you want to say in other words, both transcription and translation are not coupled there in the eukaryotic organism. They are taking place at a separate space. This is one space and this is another space, and they are taking place as a separate time. This is first time in which the transcription is taking place, and another time only the translation is being done with the help of ribosomes that have been present there. The next important difference that have been existing there between the prokaryote and eukaryote at the level of the genetic feature or at the genome feature is histones. Histones are absent in bacteria. However, some kind of histones are present there in the archaea, that is other group of bacteria. Histones are common things that are associated there with the DNA of the eukaryotic organism. That is, eukaryotic organisms DNA will be always complexed with the histone protein. These histone proteins are playing a role there in the protection of the particular DNA molecule. You look at this image. This image shows the structure of the histone molecule that have been present there in the eukaryotic organisms. Look at the histone molecules here. You can able to see the DNA here. So this thread-like thing is actually the DNA. However, these are all the histone molecules. So you can able to see the histone molecules here. There are various kinds of histones are there. Okay. These are all belongs to one kind of histone. Say for example, this one is referred as a H1 histone. This may be the other forms of histone. The DNA molecules are winded there on the histone molecules. These histone molecules basically made up of basic proteins like arginine, and they help in the protection of the DNA molecule. The next genetic difference between the prokaryote and eukaryotes is the sensitivity towards the diphtheria toxin. Bacteria are resistant, however, archaea are having a susceptible feature. Okay, that is, they are susceptible for the antibiotic, that is diphtheria toxin. However, eukaryotes are all commonly sensitive, that is they are also susceptible. If you look at into the various points so far we have discussed, this histone as well as sensitivity towards the diphtheria toxin is having some similarity there in archaea and eukaryotes. That is, both archaea and eukaryotes share some features that are similar. That is, both found to have histone there in their DNA, and both were sensitive or susceptible towards the diphtheria toxin. This is the reason we need to understand that during the course of evolution, some traits or some characteristic features have been shared across the domains of life.